Guy, my phone just fell. What up, you guys? It's your girl Elodie Zone. So you guys, I have literally not done one of these videos where I just sit down and talk to you guys in so long, so I figured y'all know, why not? After all, I don't want my YouTube channel getting watered down. Be pretty interesting to make a video about all of my thirsty nigga encounters. I've noticed in France and just mainly in Europe, and I think in the States, even though I've never been there, people are a lot more open when it comes to showing that they want you. Literally, if they want you, they gonna show you that they want you, and they gonna make sure that they get you, even though there's no chance of them getting you. They finna show you that they want to. They finna show you that they want you. Anyway, let me just get right into the video before this video becomes extremely long. We want to keep this thing short and to the point. Okay, that was honestly not even that funny. So this video was actually inspired by something that happened to me yesterday on the train. So I had gone shopping, bought a few gifts for some of my homies and a few shoes for myself. And on my way back home, I went into the metro. For those of you that don't know, a metro is the underground train. And so I'm just patiently waiting and standing there. All of the seats were taken because, I don't know, Paris is just too full. No, but seriously, I really am full. So obviously, the only other option I had was to stand. So on the next metro stop, some guy walks in, yeah. And when he enters, he looks at me, looks away, and then glances back, kind of like, oh shit! He saw this Africanness and he could not resist. So this guy comes and literally stands right next to me. Like, when I mean right next to me, I mean right next to me. And so I'm kind of just there like, but I mean, I didn't say anything, I was trying to keep it cool. So, you know, we're standing there and literally I wasn't getting off until like 4 or 5 metro stops like down. So I had no option but to just kind of stand there awkwardly. What you doing though? What you doing though? And then there's one metro stop that we stopped at where a large number of the people in the train actually came off, which then meant there were a whole bunch of seats and space to stand that was free. But no, 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 baby. No, 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 he wouldn't move. This brother from another mother stayed right in front of me and refused to evacuate or vacate himself to another seat or another space on the metro. And I'm starting to sweat. Like, it's getting hot. Like, there's just sweat all over my face. And then I started to wonder, oh my God, what if this guy tries to hurt me? At this point, my mind needs to stay sharp. If this homie pulled a move, you in my space, bubble off in a cut it. At some point, I remember eventually coughing a bit, like, just to kind of make him realize that I'm feeling awkward. When I coughed, he was staring at the ground. So this nigga literally looks up and looks at me like, you like your eggs fertilized? Like, rah! So he just keeps staring at me awkwardly, not even freaking moving. And it got to a point where I'm like, you know what? Just ignore this brother and you won't be fine, girl. Ignore this brother and your ass gonna get off the train alive, girl. There have been so many racist encounters that I have had in this country that I was not gonna take a risk. Because if I had opened my big ass mouth, this nigga could have killed my ass. So anyway, I composed myself. I was calm, I was patient, I was chill. So on my metro stop, I looked at him and I'm like, oh, pardon, excusez-moi. And I took myself off the train and then I'm just like, girl, just walk fast. And then you hear this sound that goes like, beep. And when the metro makes that sound, it usually makes that sound before the doors close. So I glanced back. And as the metro doors are closing, I see this nigga diving through and between the doors and hops out of the train just as the doors shut. So So I look back in front and I'm like, girl, walk, 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 go, 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 go. You guys, I had gotten myself into a pickle. So as I'm walking, I'm trying to be fast, trying to make sure that he doesn't catch up to me. I just feel someone grab my arm. After he grabbed my arm, this is what happened. And goes, oh, bonjour, madame. So I'm just like, okay, let me be calm, let me just act natural, be polite, and see what happens. He starts mumbling off in French and he's like, oh, blah, 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 blah. So I look at him and I'm like, oh, désolé, monsieur, je ne parle pas beaucoup français, je parle anglais. So I'm thinking, all right, phew, I've told this guy I can speak English, I'm chill. Then he goes, ah, that's all right, I speak English too, bruh. So he goes on and on and on, talking about my African beauty. He thought I was an African queen. Hello though, King Zone, hello. But I mean, you know, I just kind of said, oh, thank you very much. Trying to play it calm. But in my head, I'm just like, how the heck am I gonna get myself through this one? My responses literally need to be sharp and on point. And then he goes, can I get your number? You know, girls, when they don't wanna give you their number, they'll tell you to give them your number and that they'll call you and then they won't. But something I hadn't realized is that niggas have already figured that out. So they're already one step ahead. Because when they're busy dialing in their digits in your cell phone, they finna call themselves to get your number, you feel me? I didn't think that through. So he actually just took my phone, put in his number, dialed himself, saved my number. So that was my thirsty nigga encounter. I know I made it a bit dramatic, but hey, that's what YouTube is for. Anyway, you guys, do not forget to give this video a thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and that's what's up. Bye! By the way, like when he was introducing himself, he's like, babe, my name is Jean. Your name is what? My name is Jean. Your name is what? My name is Jean. Oh, nice to meet you, Joe. Jean. Jean, Jean, my name is Jean. Oh, your name is John. You spell it Jean, but it's pronounced Jean. Bye, nigga.